To get the guns out of this family's home in Lehigh Acres. Deputies say mom is a convicted felon. Her son, Philip Byrd, is accused of threatening a mass shooting at an elementary school. And now her other son, Andrew, is involved in a death investigation. You're watching NBC2. I'm Kelly Burns.
And I'm Peter Bush. Investigators say he built a so-called ghost gun, and that gun was used in the accidental death of a 17-year-old girl. NBC2's Samantha Serban explains what a ghost gun is and why deputies say it is important to get all weapons away from this family.
A ghost gun is untraceable. Basically, you can buy the base of a gun just like this, often called the 80%, then find the other parts to finish the gun online. It only took me a few minutes to find this website where all of this can be done and there's no registration involved.
Lee County deputies say back on July 18th, they responded to this house on Oakfield Avenue in Lehigh Acres. Neighbors sent me these pictures where you can see investigators and crime scene tape. We now know a 17-year-old girl was killed using a ghost gun made by Andrew Byrd. Forensic studies professor Dave Thomas explains a ghost gun starts with a blank.
It's easy to get your hands on the blank, the 80%. You can go on the internet right now. Boom, and have it shipped directly to your house.
Then all you have to do is get the other 20%. Court records show Byrd told deputies he builds these guns, including the one used in what's preliminarily being called an accidental self-inflicted gunshot. Thomas says he could see investigators building a case of culpable negligence.
Keep in mind that if guns are in a house, they are supposed to be secure. That's by Florida state statute. So I can see the state attorney reaching or creating a case where it was culpable negligence.
Byrd's mom says she didn't know her teenage son had or was building weapons inside the house. She was concerned because
when we look at the Byrd brothers, the Byrd family, they're no stranger to law enforcement.
Byrd's mom is a convicted felon who cannot have firearms or ammo, and his little brother is accused of threatening a mass shooting at Harns Marsh last year. Given those two facts and the recent death investigation,
it's scary. It's scary. I don't want violent people who are literally, they're going against all the rules to be around firearms. And I need to make certain that a person like that doesn't have the ability to carry out a horrific act.
As investigators continue working the death investigation, LCSO and Andrew Byrd will head to court next week, where a judge will decide Byrd's future when it comes to the Second Amendment. Reporting for NBC2, I'm Samantha Serban.